Hi, everybody. Well, my art card is still drying. So I did put the napkin down. I cut it out from a totally different piece because it was just, it was a goner. It's over here still. I might find a use for it, but I'm not going to fuss with it anymore. So this is my card. I'm not quite done. I haven't done some stamping that I wanted to do, and I still wanted to do the edge. So this ink pad is really great. But I do have a problem with the lids don't really fit together that well. So I'm just going to edge the card with this green, and that's what I edged the sentiment with. Happy fall. Happy fall to you all. And I hope that everything starts looking up. My thoughts and prayers are with the families that lost a loved one in Las Vegas this past weekend, and with all those that were injured. I'm so sorry for that. It causes me to feel absolutely so sad. So sad that I really can't stand it. So I'm going to leave that alone now, and I'm going to move on to my. I just think that this is so beautiful already, like it is. I just want to stamp a little bit more on it and outline the birds, I think. Thanks. So this is Inktober, and the drawing that I'm thinking of is, this is what happens when the edge is not reinforced and the tie is tight. So I think I'm gonna put some clear tape on that. So this was my number one. And this was my number two. I did that earlier today. So very soon it's gonna be midnight, and I'm gonna do a number three. I'm gonna do it right now because my time is gonna get very short in a couple of days, so I may do a couple ahead of time. And I hope you can see that very well. I've been wanting to do this tree for a long time with the swirls. And so I would like to do an eye today, tonight, and I'll date it because this is for 10/3/17, and this is number three. So this eye isn't going to be normal at all, I don't think. Who knows, it could be more normal than most. So there's the top of the eye and the bottom of the eye. And then we're going to have a
second eyelid. A second eyelid at the top and a second eyelid at the bottom. And this is going to be kind of a sleepy eye. He or she's gonna have some bit of bags under the eyes. And a couple of extra folds. And we have to have some hairy eyebrows. Kids that I watch, they know how to do the shading is just, it's just awesome. This grayscale that they can create with just ink and a brush, just ink. Certain kinds of ink I'm learning do that more than other kinds of ink. These are kind of, this poor guy is, he's really in bad shape. He's been out all night and he's got, if I could use color, which I don't allow myself to use color for Inktober, this is his bloodshot eye. I would have this red. So he's had a rough night. That hasn't dried yet, so I better back off of there. It's still not dry. So I'll have to, I could dry it right now, but I'm not, I don't want to too much. I'm just gonna put an outline on this baby. Sometimes when the Sharpie markers get old, they don't mark so well, except they do leave a grayscale. So maybe this will help. Too much. There we go. Well, that's my attempt at an eye that has had a rough night, and I did that on purpose. So thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe if you're not subscribed to me. Leave a thumbs up, and I would really like your sweet comments. Thank you so much. Talk to you later.